Alright everyone, MikeMoneyGMR here, and welcome back to more Let's Play Metal Gear Solid 4. We need to set up ourselves for fighting, because we got a bunch of people after us. That will be a good idea. Let's see. That's not going to help us, because we're going to be killing people, not putting them to sleep. This doesn't hold enough bullets. Let's see. Perfect. Alright, hold on a second. Let's look at that syringe real quick. Pin-shaped syringe given to Snake by Naomi, a single-hand operation. Contains a drug that temporarily suppresses nanomachine activity within the body. Restores depleted psych in one burst, though abuse will dilute the drug's effectiveness and harm the body with its severe side effects. Alright, so basically, I'm not going to equip that, from what I'm thinking, because that sounds like a bad idea. Remember, this time, unlike before, we don't have people helping us.
But you take it a step further. You have a competitor's laptop, a PC-based laptop,
yes,
with an Apple sticker over their brand, mm-hmm, over their logo, mm-hmm, on that laptop. So people from a distance think you're on a PowerBook or something.
Yeah. Well, that's actually I customize inside as well. So because at home I've always been an Apple user, and it's I changed the inside as well, and it's I don't know, it's just more fun when you're working,
right?
You don't get dull, and you want to work on a computer that you love.
Well, you like to be that rebel, you know.
Yeah,
well. But it's funny. But it's funny because you don't have to be a rebel if you're outside of Japan, like especially like in the States. Mm. You know, you see Macintosh, you see MacBooks, and
yeah,
all over the place. But
yeah,
but really, the iPod is synonymous with MP3 players,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
and so we've gotten the game. Did you have to go through a bunch of different checks?
Well, like, yeah, I did a couple of rounds of trying to get approvals, but what I did was, this was really cool. They actually wanted to see how what you guys are playing right now, how this will work. So what I did was, I went to the studio and I made a video with, you know, the staff of Kojima Productions. Thanks, guys. And we made a video, a cool video, and made sure that can be played on an iPod as well.
Oh, slick. You know?
So I sent that DVD over to Apple, and they really loved it, and they gave me approval on that. So
oh, cool.
Screenshots, usually, you know, this happens only on screenshots and text-based.
They want to see in motion, right?
Yeah, so, you know, usually you kind of ask them to come into the studio and that kind of thing, but that was...
It's kind of sad that their body just turns to ash afterwards. Alright, so what's my way out of here? So the main way is blocked. Probably just gotta shoot them all. Yes. Actually, I wonder. I doubt it actually has a thing in this game, but maybe I should try taking her out with a weapon to, you know, actually knock her out instead of trying to kill her. I'm not looking it up, so don't worry. Doesn't seem to be doing anything. So I'm actually curious to try to sneak up on her if I can. Nice! Punching her actually did seem to take out her stuff a little bit, her stamina. Of course, I can't grab her because she doesn't actually sit on the ground. So it seems that for this type of fight, you gotta just take her out. No, it's doing damage to you. But if you want me to do something more damaging to you, I sure as hell can. Let's see here. Ready, press the R2 button to launch a grenade. Okay. That actually seemed to work really well against her. I mean, I can't really see a difference in her health. But it seems like shooting her from behind is not the option. I know you're in here somewhere, but I don't know where. Wait a second. Darn, I was hoping that it would help, but it doesn't seem to help much. I like how her laugh's kind of manly. It's weird. So now I gotta be very cautious. Because what she'll do is she'll try to grab you whenever she's hitting, if you come near her by accident. Man, this fight is intense as fuck. So she was hiding in a doorway before, apparently. Nope, those are attached. Unfortunately, this means I might accidentally walk right into her, but I need to let that charge. Wait, which one has the red inside? Okay, it's charged enough. Shoo. Aha! So you can somewhat see her with the night vision if you're careful. Whoa. Remember, the old rule applies, if I die before I manage to actually accomplish anything, then I'm definitely gonna have to look this up, so yeah. So those are bombs that try to chase you down. I should have known that that was too good to be true. I was like, I know there was no dead body. Like, dead bodies do not just stand around. Thankfully, I'm right. Sure, I'll shoot you right in the face. Where are you?
Help me.
It's another mimic. Watch out, Snake.
Yeah, I'm not a dumbass, buddy. Oh yeah, by the way, I could be using Kodak help here.
That beast seems to laugh at everything.
At this point, no matter what you say to her, she'll only respond one way.
The symptoms resemble those seen in Ganser syndrome. It's a type of dissociative disorder characterized by irrelevant responses to the situation at hand. It often manifests itself in soldiers under extreme battlefield stress.
You mean she's not having a good time out here?
I doubt it. I'm starting to wonder if she might not have some kind of deep-seated psychological trauma.
Ah. What do you have to say for me, Otacon?
Snake. Octopus's suit seems to work the same way as your octocam. It'll use mimicry and traps as weapons against you. Stay focused. Don't be deceived by its disguises.
You don't have to tell me twice. I already learned the hard way what to do during this. Too good to die now. There we go. She seems to be through hiding. Oh my god. Wrong button. Not taking any chances here. To say, is this it or is there more? Phew. Unfortunate.
I am an octopus. An eight-legged beast. These tentacles are beyond my control. Their will is the will of the battle.
Ew.
Funny. So funny. It's all so funny. No. It's not funny. Nothing is funny. I shouldn't be laughing. I can't. The truth is, I'm not laughing. Not laughing at all. I shouldn't be laughing.
Wow.
I'm scared. I'm really scared. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. So sorry I laughed. I'm sorry. I won't laugh anymore. I can't.
And yet you just did.
I don't want to.
Shouldn't you be dead by now? I thought you couldn't stay away from your outfit. Nice suit, by the way, though.
Who knows what she'll throw at you next? Watch out!
Otacon, what do I do?
From the looks of it, she's unarmed. And yet, she's coming closer. I don't know what she's up to, but watch out, Snake!
Anything else?
From the looks of it, she's...
Okay. know if I can actually hit her with this. Because she moves so much. Apparently it's working, though. I wonder if you let her get too close, if she just insta-kills you. That's why I'm, like, staying fucking far as possible away. Like, I don't know if I can harm her physically, you know, basically is what I'm trying to say here. Well, this appears to be working. Ow! Pretty. Is that what I get for leaving her alive, or was I gonna get that anyway? By the way, because one thing I can tell you is that if you don't know, she actually does have, like, it actually vibrates as if she has a heartbeat.
Yo, Snake. Looking good today.
Driven. What do you want?
That's cold, man. And here I was about to tell my very best customer about face camo.
Face camo?
That camo skull cap you just picked up from Tentacle's shell. It utilizes the same kind of technology as your Octo Camo suit. Using the two together can get you even better results. I'd hang on to it if I was you.
Doesn't fit. It's not my size or shape.
Yeah. Looks like it could use a bit of tailoring before you can sport it. Not my line of work, but... ain't you got a buddy who specializes in that kind of thing?
Somebody has done their homework.
Hey, is my job.
Is that the real reason you injected me with those nanomachines? To spy on me?
I prefer the term customer data management myself.
Driven.
Relax. It's strictly confidential. I ain't gonna share it with anybody.
Then what did you mix a virus in with the nanomachines for?
Virus?
A certain virus was detected in my body. Are you saying it wasn't in the nanomachines you injected?
Look, you do know there are other folks who could have done this to you. And besides, what would I gain from infecting you? Better for me that you're out there kicking ass on the battlefield. I was watching you, Snake. You're a real piece of work. Never thought I'd meet the man who could take down Laughing Octopus single-handedly. She just kept on laughing. Now why do you suppose that is?
Something in her past.
You got it. She's from a village in Scandinavia. Little seaside hamlet known to all the locals as the Devil's Village. Place wasn't known for devils, though. It was known for octopus. See, this was one of the few places in Europe where they ate octopus customarily. Anyway, there's this cult of crazies who for some reason hate the village with a passion. Then, when she was just a teenager, things get bad. These nutcases get their hands on some weapons and attack the village. Overnight, her sleepy little fishing town becomes a war zone. They round up all the villagers and execute them one by one. Except for that girl. They had something else planned for her. Something a whole lot worse than dying. Calling her the Devil's Child, they forced her to do the kind of thing you'd expect from one of Lucifer's own. After they made her torture her family and friends, they made her kill them. The whole time they were forcing her to laugh, howl like some sort of demon, like she was enjoying it. What was she gonna do? Say no? They'd kill her too. So she let fear take control and did exactly as they told her. She butchered the bodies of the ones she loved and laughed while she did it. And as she bathed in their blood, it gradually turned from deep red to jet black. To her, it looked like the ink of an octopus. The experience scarred her deep. Ever since then, she hasn't stopped laughing. Only, that ain't really laughter.
Why are you telling me this? You expect me to feel sorry for her?
Nah. I know you got no room for that stuff in your world. And besides, this is war. Right? In a way, though, I guess it was the right thing to do.
What was?
Fighting you cleansed her mind. All right, enough chit-chat. There's other beasts out there in them woods. Watch your back.
Camouflage Skullcap that uses the same kind of technology as Octo Camo. Combining with Octo Camo significantly increases camouflage effect. Now, you won't get this if you kill her. I had to look it up because I was curious. And sure enough, the guide I looked up, I just looked up the boss fact. I didn't look up any of the other ones or anything like that. It's just, like, it doesn't tell you anything about the game except for this girl. And it says, you can lethally kill the, like, basically, it counts as, like, killing them a lot faster, basically. Like, since you can, like, you have to use it because otherwise, like, it doesn't count. Like, basically, if you're going for a non-death run, which is something you can do in this game, it says that to take these characters out, you want to do it with a gun first, and then use the silencer afterward. Like, not the silencer, this knockout gun afterwards, because that way you get the face camo. Now, if you kill her, you won't get it, and it doesn't give you anything. Like, basically, you get absolutely nothing for killing them, and it also counts as though you lethally killed them, you know, as well. So it's a really bad idea. Oh, and by the way, stun grenades actually will work. I didn't use them, but whatever. Yeah. Phew. Oh, good to know. Anyway, let's go ahead and hit X on this. Camouflage skull that uses the same kind of technology, shaped to resemble Laughing Beauty's face. About 47 minutes. That's not bad for how long that I thought that took. Fortunately, I'm probably gonna have to do... Well... Let's keep going, because I need to see if this is a stopping point. I get it.
Snake, have you lost sight of the target? Whenever something moves, it leaves a trail behind. Track and find Naomi's trail.
I'm not like Big Boss. Tracking isn't my strongest suit. When did you get so good at it?
After saving Sunny, I drifted around the globe. In Alaska, a tribal elder taught me some scouting techniques.
Drifted? You never went back to see Rose?
Rose? She doesn't exist. No. Rose and I live in different worlds, different times. Her world has no place for someone like me. My place is here on the battlefield. Listen, Snake. Scouting is based on the principles of hunting. There are two fundamentals. Awareness and tracking.
Awareness?
Awareness refers to locating a trail by paying careful attention to your surroundings. Tracking means to follow that trail. Your target's trail could be footprints, a branch they broke along the way, bent grass trampled underfoot. You need to feel for clues using all your senses. Sound, smell, touch, the direction of the wind. Watch how the animals move. Listen for unusual bird calls. These are signs that someone may be disrupting the environment nearby.
You sound like a ninja.
Exactly. Ninja are the ultimate scouts. If your enemy is a skilled scout, they'll be doing the same thing. You may be the hunter, but you are also the hunted. To avoid enemy detection, move slowly, little by little. Don't disturb the air around you. Try to make as little noise as possible. Your pursuers will be doing the same, trying to sneak up on you without a sound. If you can't pick up the trail with your naked eye, switch the solid eye to infrared mode. That will enable you to see Naomi's footprints and any enemies lying in ambush.
Switch the solid eye to infrared. Got it.
But the sound it makes while engaged could end up giving your position away. So don't leave it on for too long.
All right.
Interesting.
Listen to your heart. Trust your senses as much as you can. And you will find Naomi's trail.
I'll give it a shot.
Snake, follow Naomi's trail and find out where they took her. Watch out, though. You might run into a few holdups along the way.
Let me look at that real quick. So yeah. That seems to be a good point. So hopefully that is correct. Okay guys, I gotta end the session for today, I'm afraid, and also at the same time I got to basically I do want to do more of this, but it'll be a while till I can do more, unfortunately. I will also make sure to get as many of these uploaded as possible, like as fast as possible, as always. So yeah. Anyway, I will see you guys when I record next. Till then, everyone. Bye.